Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Sapphire here. First of all, I just want to say I'm so sorry that I've been MIA for a long time. Yeah, it's been about 3 weeks, maybe four, I'm not exactly sure, but I've been so busy vacationing and just enjoying life, and I hope you guys have been too. With that being said, it is Saturday around 8 o'clock in the morning, and construction is being done in my house later on around 9:30. So I decided that, you know what, on behalf of my Dubai review video, why not throw on a turban? And I really hope that it doesn't offend anyone. It's not my intention at all. But I also just didn't feel like doing my hair, so yeah. Carrying on, if you are new to my page, be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. I post new videos every week, except for the last few weeks I've been like all over the place. But I will be more consistent. And if you like what you see, hit the like button. Also, I'll just say this now, comment down below if you feel like I didn't cover anything that you wanted to know about Dubai, and I definitely will comment back and give you to the best of my ability, my opinion. So, let's get started. When you think of Dubai, you think of expensive, right? But in this video, I'm going to talk to you about ways to plan your Dubai travel to the most cost-efficient way possible. I'll also talk about things to see and things to do and things that I did enjoy experiencing but I might have could have done without, or maybe not, because I do think every experience is worth the experience, but it wasn't as exciting as I expected it to be, and that's normal and that's okay. So I'll tell you guys and you make the decision for yourselves if you think it's worth it. Alright, tip number one, it is hot year-round in Dubai, being hotter in the months of June, July, and August. And as per the locals, they say that it is unbearably hot during those months, so I really wouldn't want to travel there during those months. Maybe for the experience in the future, but not for my first time there, not being able to enjoy everything that I would want to enjoy in such hot climate. You want to book your trip during the off-season times, like I did. We went in March, and the weather was honestly perfect. The weather was so good to us. There was a sandstorm, yeah, and everybody else had masks. I guess they knew they were comfortable. But tourists, they were like, all right, sandstorm, we're still going out. We actually went to the beach that day. Aside from that, though, the weather was beautiful. It was warm, yet cool enough to wear a quarter sleeve shirt, or if you wanted to wear a loose fitting long sleeve shirt. Tip number two, buy a package deal. That includes flight and hotel. I know it seems obvious, but a lot of people think when you're traveling somewhere so far or somewhere that sounds so expensive like Dubai or Hawaii, they look for cheaper flight, cheaper hotel, and it comes out to be more expensive because those things, they include taxes when you do a package deal. For the most part, obviously you want to read the fine print, but for the most part, they include a full price when you get there, like taxes included and all. I will say that Dubai has a law though, that there is like a stay tax when you get there, but that's like $3, and it's $3 per day, per guest. So that's not that bad. You pay that at the hotel. That's the only thing that's not included, because Expedia has, or the third party has no control over that. Tip number three, take public transportation. Not only is it fast and convenient, it's absolutely stunning. You get to see the entire city from up top in lightning speed through these completely spotless windows that look like there isn't even a window there. But it's so worth it to experience, any way you travel, it's worth it to experience their public transportation and compare it to yours. Dubai's public transportation is absolutely stunning. Plus, the taxi rate is so high there. We didn't really understand that or know that much, so we took taxi pretty much everywhere. I think we only took the public transportation once, which was probably our biggest regret, or my biggest regret, because I would have enjoyed doing that again. Again, we were only there for three and a half days. So take public transportation as much as you can. When we went to Singapore, we took Uber everywhere, and Uber was so much cheaper than traveling with the taxis, and I wish I knew that traveling to Dubai. So do Uber in Dubai, do public transportation, but do public transportation more. Tip number four is about food. Now, food is expensive. Everywhere you go, it's so expensive. Really, really. So,
really, really.
So my suggestion would be, kind of contradicts itself, but my suggestion would be, if you are the type of person who doesn't really care much about like dining, then eat fast food. Because it's convenient. There's fast food restaurants everywhere. And from what I hear, we didn't eat any fast food. We've seen plenty. But from what I hear, it is different from the States. I don't know about other countries, but in the States, it's different. And it actually tastes pretty decent. But on the other hand, if you enjoy dining, like I do, like Monica does, for the most part, you eat out, and I do think it's Dubai, so it's worth it to eat out or spend a little extra cash on your food. Especially for us, we were only there for a short amount of time, so it wasn't like someone who was staying for longer than a week and you were eating out all the time. That can be like another big expense. So eat at fast food restaurants. That brings me to tip number five, I believe. Don't go for more than 4 or 5 days. And I say this only because Dubai is all about architecture. These large, beautiful, amazing buildings. And if you are an architect junkie, you're gonna run out of things to do. So there's plenty to do, but for a vacation, you're gonna run out of things to do. Unless you are going to Dubai for relaxation, which I would love to do one day. I was going for sightseeing things, but I would love to go to Dubai for relaxation. It is so peaceful. Nobody bothers you. Everybody goes about their business, and it is such a comfortable environment. Like I was so comfortable there, like in my skin, the weather was perfect. So that's my tip about timing your travel. Tip number six, dress comfortably, fashionable. Now I know that might sound like, what, really? But when you go to Dubai, you see all these beautiful women, and they are dressed so comfortably, yet so fashionably, and so cultural. And it really, like, it makes you feel like you want to get dressed up and look cute, because everybody looks so good. Even the men, like, they look handsome and decent and really nice. So we obviously weren't in our most, you know, weren't decked out in our coolest threads, but I feel like we did a good job dressing wise, but I think I could have done a little better to, you know, to spruce it up a bit. But I do think that's something that you want to keep in mind, to dress comfortably, fashionable. I also want to say that you do not have to wear long sleeves or cover your hair or long pants. There were people who went in short shorts, belly shirts, which I think is like really disrespectful, but you can do that if you want. My opinion, I do feel like you should have just a little bit consideration for the people of the country, because just have a little bit of modesty. Because it might make people feel uncomfortable. Remember, you're visiting someone else's homeland. So just be a little considerate. That's my piece of advice to you. I did wear a tank top at some point, and I had my arms out at some point, but I wasn't gonna go all the way and wear shorts. That wasn't gonna work out, not in Dubai. And honestly, I chose to wear a turban on my hair because I just wanted to. And to be honest, I felt the most beautiful I've ever felt in my life covering my hair. I don't know why. Maybe it's because, like, you can see nothing but your face. And I was kind of ish conservative. I don't know. Well, I was kind of modest. Not really, but, like, Covering my hair made me feel like I had nothing to show but my face, and it makes you appreciate your beauty more. I hope you guys can feel me what I mean. Tip number 7 is handling customer service. Now, I'm gonna sound like I'm complaining for the next 2 tips, I think, but customer service is like, you have to wait for everything. Now, we go to a restaurant, you wait for someone to come to you for a really long time, not just talking a normal wait time, and I don't know if I am an impatient person, so that could be it, but Monica's not an impatient person, and she was like, oh, really? And I was like, oh, really? But when you sit down at a restaurant, they take long to come to you. They take long to bring, like, your water. They take long to come back and bring your food. They take long to, even longer, to bring you your bill, even longer to take, bring back your card. Everything is like a waiting game everywhere you go in Dubai. Now, I don't know if that's because it's a cultural thing, like, and I respect that if it is, but if it's not, and it's for some other reason, which I don't want to say out loud because I don't want to believe those things, but if it's a cultural thing, I do feel like they want us to enjoy our time, enjoy the moment, enjoy the time with your family or your friends, and not feel rushed. I appreciate that. I do. But it was a lot to handle for a person like me who just like has no patience whatsoever. Tip number 8, be mindful of the hotel you book and the flight that you book. Now, I say this because when you are booking off season and you are booking for such a cheap price, we paid $915 for a flight and hotel, which is pretty decent, think about it, for a combined deal like that. But when you have such a cheap deal, you might end up staying at a business hotel like we did. And that's not all bad. Business hotels are generally pretty quiet, which I enjoy quiet time. I really do. But I also enjoy meeting new people and hanging out with people my age. I didn't see any of that, not one. Like, it was really a business hotel. And they kind of look at you like, what are you doing here? And it's not the people who are from there. It is the American business people who are visiting. Like, they look at you a little bit side-eye-ish. But that's the one thing you want to keep in mind. But who really cares about that? I have Monica either way, and I'm pretty sure you're not going alone. But if you are going alone, just consider the hotel. You might not meet much people if you're not going there for business. As far as the flight goes, we didn't realize until we were coming back that we had a 7-hour layover in Qatar Airport. That was the most beautiful airport I've ever seen in my life. But it was 12 o'clock midnight to 7 o'clock in the morning, 7:30 in the morning. Where are we going in Qatar at that hour? It really, really sucks to be in a country that you would enjoy visiting but can't because of the hour of your layover. It really sucks, but it is worth it. I can always go back to Qatar and visit if I ever plan to in the future. But it is worth it to get that cheaper deal so that you can enjoy your final destination or, you know, the objective of the travel plan. So that is a tip. Just be mindful that might happen to you. Read your itinerary thoroughly, because I did it and I was like, wait, what? We're not leaving in an hour or two? She's like, no, you leave at 7:15 a.m. I'm like, what? What do you mean? Our flight left? She's like, no, this is the flight hour. Like, this is your confirmation. It leaves at that time. So we had no choice but to sleep at the airport and have delusional laughs, because I'm telling you, you get a little bit fuzzy up there after the hours, and it's just, yeah. Places to see, things to do. Number 1, at some point during your travel, you must visit the spice souk. The spice souk is, souk means like market or shopping area, but I think it translates to market and spice. So they sell spices at the spice souk, and souvenirs, and just a bunch of stuff that you can buy and bring back home with you. Now, The spice souk is probably my second favorite part of the trip. I'll save the best for last. My second favorite part of the trip was the spice souk. You see so much culture there. You see all of these people from all over the world coming together, bringing their differences together as one, and making money, doing what they do. And it's really nice, and you would expect, you know when you go places and they are really pushy with trying to sell you something? Well, they weren't like that until you got into the store. Once you showed interest, then they were pushy. But when you're walking past outside, they weren't really, or maybe they were. They were, but like, you knew which ones were the ones that were like pushy. They were the ones that had nobody in front of or inside their stores. Obviously, they're gonna be pushy because they want customers. But for the most part, it wasn't an uncomfortable feeling at all. We felt really comfortable, really safe, and really appreciative of the moment. Number two, Jumeirah. I'm gonna put it up top, but I just can't pronounce that name. Beach. And this beach is so peaceful, and you get to see the Burj Al Arab. And this is just a tall building that looks really cool, but it's a must see and a must take pics in front of. Number three, the Miracle Garden. Yeah, I know you guys see pictures everywhere of the Miracle Garden because this is a landmark of Dubai, but pictures do no justice. This garden is so unbelievably breathtaking. Like, it's so beautiful. They have a plane, an Emirates plane, that's like flowered out. They have bridges that are flowered out, heart shapes, huge, ginormous hearts that are like flowered out. It's so beautiful. You have to see it. I can't really go into too much detail because there's not really much to say besides experience it and wear your pretty dresses and take pretty pictures. Make sure you go with your best friend who's like gonna tolerate your annoyingness to take pictures of you. Number four, a desert safari. I won't go into full detail either on this as to what a desert safari offers because different companies offer different packages, but for the most part, most of them offer a cultural experience, meaning cultural food, cultural music, cultural activities such as henna, or you get to wear an outfit that covers up. I forget the name of it. I'm so sorry, and I don't mean to offend anyone because I forgot the name of the outfit. If I figure it out, I'll put it on the screen. If not, sorry. But you get to take pictures in that, and it's pretty cool. Like, the whole experience. We did a camel ride, we did dun ride, we did, they had a skirt dance. I forgot the name of that dance too. They did belly dancing. We had food. They had hookah, which we didn't do. They had henna, which we also didn't do because we just didn't. And this is all included in your package. And what else did they have for us? Oh, how could I forget? We had the ATV experience as well in the desert, which is so cool. Number five is the Burj Khalifa. Now, the Burj Khalifa, before we had our appointment to go up inside the Burj Khalifa all the way to the top, we went to the mall and we seen it from outside where they have these beautiful fountains that plays music and dances to the music. But the Burj Khalifa lights up like sparkly, and you have to take pictures in front of it. Because unfortunately, when you actually have your appointment to get into the Burj Khalifa, as expected, the line is really long to get in. But once you get in, the elevator jets up like so fast. It's kind of cool. And you get all the way to the top, you get out, and the view sucks. You can't see much. And I kind of am hoping it's because the sandstorm that day, there was a sandstorm. But there wasn't a sandstorm at the moment, but it could have fogged everything up. And it was just like, you couldn't see any much lights. It wasn't, I have one picture where you can see something, but you can't see much. And there are workers there with a green screen ready to take pictures of you so they can like manually input an image of the view. Are you kidding me? why, that's crazy to me. I don't know if that's normal, but that sounds crazy to me. Yeah, so mind you, the worst part of it all is the line to get down is longer than the line to come up. And you have people so close to you, We had the belly man all up on us. Like, his belly was so hard and round and all on your back. Really warm. And like, he was pushing on you. And it was like, back up off me. It was crazy. The line was so long. And by the time you get down, you're so exhausted, you really don't want to do anything that night. Plan this on the night that you don't really expect to do much after. Now, for number six, my favorite part of my Dubai travel was definitely visiting the Grand Mosque. This is in Abu Dhabi with, we also want to see the Grand Palace. And let me start off with the mosque. Like the Miracle Garden, pictures do no justice. It is phenomenal. It is huge. It is clean. It is quiet. It is peaceful. It is cultural. It is everything that you can imagine. I wish that, like, I wouldn't want it to be like a tourist thing where people can just stay and chill out and have a bite. But I wish I could have done that. I wish I could have stayed there longer. I wish that I could have experienced people praying. We didn't really experience that. But you have to go. It is like another world there. I see why people travel from all over the world to go there. Just to go there. It is unbelievable. Then, as far as like the Grand Palace, which is another place. I think it's a shopping mall, but whatever it is, it's an all gold building with like these big doors. It's just, see my pictures on Instagram. But they have these tall buildings that look like something from a movie in the future, and you have to see it. You just have to. And that's really it for my Dubai review, and I hope that you guys enjoyed it, and I hope this wasn't too long, and I hope to see you guys soon. Stay tuned. Next week Sunday, I'm going to be, a lot of people have been asking me, how do I keep my skin so clear living with lupus? And this is something that people even without lupus can do. And I hope that you guys tune in. I hope that you guys like it. And I hope you guys like this video. Thanks so much. Like always, lots of love. And bye.